you need to know that Jesus is all throughout the pages of this Bible. And we see his presence and we see his faithfulness in every book in the New Testament. And we see Jesus even in the Old Testament as well. It's all Jesus. Jesus is the story of and in the Bible. And the Gospel of Mark isn't the only place that you will find him. In Genesis, Jesus is the ram at Abraham's altar. In Exodus, he is the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, he is the high priest. In Numbers, he is the cloud by day and the pillar of fire by night. In Deuteronomy, he's our city of refuge. In Joshua, he is a scarlet thread outside of Rahab's window. In Judges, he is our judge. In Ruth, he is our kinsman redeemer. In 1 and 2 Samuel, he is our trusted prophet. In Kings and Chronicles, he is our reigning king. In Ezra, he is our faithful scribe. In Nehemiah, he is the rebuilder of everything that is broken. In Esther, he is the Mordecai, sitting right there, faithful at the gate. In Job, he's our redeemer who lives. In Psalms, he is our shepherd, and I shall not want. In Proverbs and Ecclesiastes, he is our wisdom. In the Song of Solomon, he is our bridegroom. In Isaiah, he is the wonderful counselor, the mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, who was wounded for your transgressions. In Jeremiah and Lamentations, Jesus is the weeping prophet. In Ezekiel, he is the wonderful four-faced man. In Daniel, he is the fourth man in the fiery furnace. And in Hosea, he is the picture of faithfulness. In Joel, he baptizes us with the Holy Spirit. In Amos, he's our burden bearer. In Obadiah, he's our Savior. And in Jonah, he's our great foreign missionary who takes the word of God all around the world. In Micah, he is the messenger with beautiful feet. In Nahum, he is the avenger. In Habakkuk, he's the watchman who is ever praying for revival. In Zephaniah, he is the Lord, mighty to save. In Haggai, he is the restorer of our lost heritage. In Zechariah, he is an overflowing fountain. In Malachi, he is the son of righteousness with healing in his wings. We come to the New Testament, and in Matthew, he is the son of the living God. And in Mark, you've come to know him as a miracle worker. In Luke, he is the son of man. In John, he's the door by which every one of us must enter. In Acts, Jesus is the shining light that appeared to Saul on the road to Damascus. In Romans, he is our justifier. In 1 Corinthians, he is our resurrection. In 2 Corinthians, he is our sin bearer. In Galatians, he redeems us from the law. In Ephesians, he is our unsearchable riches. In Philippians, he supplies our every need. In Colossians, he is the fullness of the Godhead in bodily form. In 1 and 2 Thessalonians, we find him to be our soon and coming king. In 1 and 2 Timothy, he is the mediator between God and man. In Titus, he is our blessed hope. And in Philemon, he is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. And in Hebrews, he is the great high priest. In James, it is the Lord who heals the sick. And in 1 and 2 Peter, he is the chief shepherd. In 1, 2, and 3 John, it is Jesus who models the tenderness of love. And in Jude, he is the Lord coming with 10,000 saints. And in Revelation, lift up your eyes, O church, for your redemption is near. For he is the Alpha and the Omega. He is the beginning and the end. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. It's all Jesus. This entire book, it's all Jesus.